creative process, there's these moments where you feel like you're connecting with something that's much bigger, and you're channeling something. And over the years, recognizing those moments as the reward for doing all of this, I think has enabled me to make those moments bigger moments, and to see that that experience is really what I'm doing. And, you know, what I'm going for is just, and not really having a clear picture of what it's going to look like, but knowing that that creative moment is going to teach me something.
It gives me chills down my spine to think about those early moments in discovering ceramics and realizing that it was the thread that wove societies together. It was the art that really brought human cultures to one, and it was represented history in a huge, huge way. And the neat thing about clay is, one of the neat things for me is that when you go to museums or you study anything in archaeology, the only thing that's for sure going to be left will be clay. Now, the pots might not be whole, but they might be shards. But if it's a broken pot, it can be reconstructed, or you can kind of pretty much guesstimate how it all looked. A lot of the pieces are missing, big chunks, but the people have still been able to reconstruct. And we can learn about what was done, what people did, how they were able to do it, how they stored things, how they fermented things, how they ate, how they did stuff.
To be able to take a piece of clay and a simple little wooden tool that you carved with some sandpaper, and to be able to create a piece of art out of just this clay and a simple wooden tool is very, very therapeutic to us. I feel like that to me is the heart and soul of ceramics, is the simple stuff.
After spending a long time working on a bunch of things and then putting them in the big kiln and opening the door, I think is like a spiritual experience. You know, all of this effort and work is all right there in front of you. So there's a certain high that I look forward to while I'm working, to get to the place where it's all complete.
And if you're innately gifted with really good eye-hand coordination and can quickly develop a sensitivity for the clay and how it moves and feel it and have a real sense of feeling through your fingers of the clay particles moving and experiencing that, then you'll progress really quickly.
There's so much knowledge to get a good foundation, to be around people that are doing it, not just talking about it. That's crucial.
It's been rewarding to realize that I am passing on these tricks and tips to the next generation, that I'm so interested in seeing the next 20 years of my life to see who makes it, who goes on to become professional potters, who of my students do I open up Ceramics Monthly, the magazine, and see their work in there someday and feel that maybe I had a splinter of effect on that situation to enable that person to get where they are.
You know, from the process of getting the clay and to opening the kiln at, you know, the last firing is a long process. So being able to change things like adding new colors or different clay bodies or firing temperatures, that's all important. So slowing the process down to where you can make tests and study all the different possibilities, that's really fun. Thank you. So this really shows all the different steps in ceramics, that there must be like 50 people here working that I have to do by myself. So I think realizing how long the ceramics production is, from making the piece to firing it, and then here at the end there's people buying it at this little store, you know, and here's a little raku kiln and a overglazing and a tea room and the big dragon kiln in the center here, and all the different people glazing and getting things ready for the kiln. So that's my little treasure.
During summer, when I'm on these multi-day workathons, you get this very, very interesting effect that happens. Where if I'm working really hard, putting in 8 to 10 hour days for a couple days, I have to work up to it. But if I start out, I'll work for a couple days and I'm getting my moves down. I'm getting my moves down and I'm really interested and I'm inspired and I'm going for it. And then by about the third or fourth day into this spree of working, I hit this peak, this pinnacle. And suddenly, I can do no wrong. Everything I do is just my fingers are doing the right thing. And I can ride this, it's almost like an artistic high that you ride out for a couple days, where I have so many ideas, they pour out of my head so fast that I have to write them down in books every time one comes so that I can save it for another time, or I'll lose it all because they just flow out of my head. And the ideas and the art that comes out of those few days is like no other. It is amazing. It's brilliant.